The power of analytics, embarking on an AI analytics and citizen data visualization journey. Now, there's this great maxim, you've all heard it, a good plan now is better than a perfect plan later. I do feel though a lot of organizations run into this conundrum when it comes to strategy and general planning, because at the end of the day, yes, you can't spend forever crafting the perfect plan for something. But on the other hand, you do not want to go into something with half-baked effort. You want to be informed. You want to know what's going on. Business intelligence and business analytics is completely core to this, and it has become so much more accessible and powerful. You do not have to reinvent the wheel in order to access great technology, specifically analytics. Business analytics have been one of the leading drivers of platform adoption for the last 20 years, I would say.
I think a lot of us feel like this. We feel overwhelmed with the amount of things that we need to look for. So whether that's a dashboard or a report to find that business insight, or scanning through our emails to find some important piece of information, we are overwhelmed. So if you feel like this, I'm here to tell you that you're not alone. We're at an exciting chapter of modern analytics, and BI and Gen AI are coming together to help sort of simplify our lives. We've got descriptive analytics. We have the ability to look at our past information, our past data, and asking what actually happened. Then moving into diagnostic, why did something happen? We're still looking at our historical data, but we have the ability to ask why something has happened. Then looking into the future, a lot of these BI tools have had these functionalities for a while, the ability to predict, the ability to forecast. How does generative AI sort of impact this type of typical BI landscape?
When I saw these concerns, when I saw this number 67%, that's a pretty high number of people that don't trust the technology. And I guess what we've seen across the region is a lot of companies have already blocked OpenAI from their corporate network because they're kind of worried about this. What this means for businesses, I think, is if your data gets shared with an AI model as part of a prompt and it gets used to train the AI model, then that data can be leaked to other people, and people have genuine concerns about that. When you think about the pace of change, we think a lot of these like risks and, you know, the opportunities will kind of evolve quite a lot over the next 6 months.
There's a lot changing here. So at the very least, as a business leader, be proactive, find out what's going on, have these conversations. I think companies are already deciding they're going to build are quite ahead of the curve. I think a lot of companies are still like, we're not too sure what to do. But this is where the platforms come in. And let's ignore the fact that this thing can write an essay. Let's talk about the fact that this thing can talk to us. This is a big deal. Think of your touchscreen, think of your mouse, think of your keyboard. Same thing's happening here, except a much more profound level. And when you combine with something like analytics, I love that demo where they show, I can just ask it questions and it can actually give me follow-up questions. I mean, that's how you search these days. So I'm very excited about this, guys. Thank you very much for giving your time today to give us a bit more information on this. Hopefully we will have you back soon, because there's so much more to unpack.